We are also asking the same question when we played Libya. We were not too sure whether the penalty we considered was a clear one or but we just leave that to the officials. We came here to play football and we respect their decisions. And I haven't seen the replay yet, so I can't comment on that. And talking about our game with Nigeria, we know this will go a long way to help Africa football, how we have some of the best countries, you know, clashing in such a tournament. It's all a plus for Africa football. So we really need to plan and work very, very hard to meet Nigerians.
From here on, we are going to pick up the pieces, learn the lessons. As you well know, in 2015, the DRC will be hosting the Under-23 Africa Cup of Nations. So for these youngsters, it was a first experience. It was a first experience, and we're going to pick up from that to prepare them better, so that we are ready to face anything that will compete at the Under-23 Africa Cup of Nations in the DRC in 2014. I try not to judge referees. I think what happened tonight, CAF has adequate or appropriate instances and institutions to deal with that situation. Nevertheless, we cannot ignore the fact that some of the refereeing mistakes that were made tonight have affected African football, the image of African football, especially when we refer to assistant referee number one. But we tried to recover from the psychological knock that we took from such actions, and we tried to remain in the game and to continue to play so that we can level up our opponent.
First and foremost, we thank the Almighty, because everything when you are doing, you have to put your trust in the Lord. Many people will regret you, but when you have God, everything is possible. I think with God, you can see everything is possible here, because we have put our trust in God, and we are working very hard, and we have the unity in the team. So it's very difficult to penetrate, and I thank God for that.